The conceptual part of hybridization is a little bit confusing and weird. But the good thing is, when you're asked questions, you're not going to be writing essays on it. You're just going to be answering questions dealing with hybridization. So we're going to look at it in a very simple way. And it's based off of the electronic geometry. We're going to say here, your hybridization of your central element is SP when your central element is connected to two groups. And remember, when you're connected to two groups, your electronic C is AX2. And if you're AX2, you're linear. If your hybridization is SP2, then your central element is connected to three groups. If it's SP3, it's four groups. SP3D, five groups. SP3D2, six groups. And the simplest way to think of it is like this. There's a power here that we don't see. 1 plus 1 gives us two groups. There's a 1 here that we don't see. 1 plus 2 gives us three groups. 1 plus 3 gives us 4. 1 plus 3 plus 1 gives us 5. 1 plus 3 plus 2 gives us 6. Simplest way to look at it. It's going and skipping a lot of the theory involved with promotion of the electron to the next available atomic orbital. We're just basically breaking it down and connecting it directly to electronic geometry. So let's take a look at the first example, and you'll see how easy it really is.